All right, Jennifer, JRPG week here on Rage Select continues.
Yes!
It's more. It's day three of so many JRPGs, and it's the dojo. It's a spaceship. Hello, I'm Jeff.
I'm Mayhem's Muse.
And we are flying through the universe into the most confusingly named Star Ocean Integrity and Faithlessness. I love it.
I love JRPG week. This is my favorite week. It's my favorite week of all time ever.
Is it better than Shark Week? Oh, shit, there's a wormhole?
It is. They're both the same thing simultaneously.
What if
because
there was
it's Shark Week right
if,
now.
What if there's JRPG Shark Week? Like where it's just nothing
even
but
better.
Sharks. Big anime eyes. They got a little teardrop on the side of their head.
Make it. They're make
very,
this
they're,
game.
They've got the little red hash marks. They're very embarrassed.
Yeah.
All right, so I don't. Like, I played about 20 minutes at the beginning of this game so that we didn't have to pay super close attention to everything.
Yeah.
I don't understand where the spaceship comes in because I was on the ground with a bunch of anime folks doing, like, killing monsters with a sword.
Well, that's what you get for fast-forwarding. You got to start at the beginning.
I totally did.
I'm really excited about this one, though. I got to play a demo of it at E3 a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
And it's so pretty. It's just so pretty.
I played a little bit of... Okay, so what do we got here? Earth.
I spent more time trying to get all the settings inverted than I did actually getting to play the actual
game. I swear to God, Tokyo Mirage Sessions...
Yeah.
Confused the shit out of me.
I'm not surprised.
Because I was like, I need to invert the... Wait, no, I don't need to... I don't understand.
God, it's so gorgeous.
All right.
Square Enix, you make such damn pretty games.
How do you say that? Sthal?
Saul. I'm
okay.
going to say Saul.
Saul? Better call Saul?
I'm going to go for TH is silent.
Okay. All
just
right.
Just because I want to.
All right. Hey, look, some guys are fighting with swords. That's...
Duke it out, bros.
Never seen that before.
All right. Who do you got your money on?
I'm going to go with blue guy. His hoodie is way more complicated.
Good, because I'm going for scrappy redhead.
Oh, yeah? Okay. No, I know
battle
how to
tutorial.
Do...
Battle tutorial.
I know how to do the battle tutorial. Oh, wait, is that it? Oh, we don't get to battle at all? All right. Is he wearing, like, a hella eyeliner? Or is that just me?
I mean, who doesn't?
Yeah. Several years have passed since you took over for your father. Oh, gee. Just changed in that time. You think so? What's more, the capital's supposedly a real scary place now. Word is someday I want to in real life like go out one day and then just like go up to one of my friends and do like a big exposition dump on them. And I meet my friend at the bar and just be like, oh man, can you believe it's been 5 years already since I moved into my new apartment? Man, we had such problems with raiders at first, but now after the Ragian Senate came to order, everything is fine. All right, so what are we doing here? We're running around.
You're taking a lap around the city, bro.
Okay, let's do it. I'm surprised this isn't a race. I can almost see. It's like, oh, you've been. Is this where we're going? I'm following you. Where are you going?
He's looking at the pretty sights.
Okay, look at all that rendered water. Let's see.
Gorgeous.
Okay, I gotta go up to the thing. Oh shit, we got a Liberty Bell in this city? Fuck yeah. Saul is the place to be.
I think it's beautiful.
Yeah.
I wanna move there.
Yeah. But where's the spaceship and the lasers?
That's later.
Is that later? God damn it.
You can't just start with the spaceship. You've gotta build to something.
Do you get a mech suit or like a dragon mech?
No, look at that cloak. Why would you need a mech suit when you have a gorgeous cloak like that?
How would I know what? Is Miki really 18 already? She looks way more mature than I. She does not.
She does not look like an 18-year-old. She looks 5.
Yeah, she looks all of like 6 years old. Can you believe she's 18 already? That's what I'm gonna say to my friend too when I'm at the bar. Can you believe I'm 38 already?
We should film a thing where we make a really bad. Like exposition-based intro scene. Like I'm in a bar having a drink, and then you walk in after your long day, and you go off on some tangent about something, just like completely deadpan.
Yeah,
just going for it.
Yep.
I like this. Also, I just hit my tooth on the microphone.
Ooh,
it's
that's
great.
It's never good.
It's the best.
That's never good. I'm pretty sure that means that that you have some kind of terrible caffeine. Coffee breath related disease. Whoa, I am standing
great.
In the wrong position for this guy.
Oh, are you?
I think so.
I think you're standing in the right position.
Ow!
You shouldn't bend over like that. Wait, do we even know his name?
Nope. And think of a plan together. Come on. Oh,
I mean, you're okay with letting them go? They'll just run away. Yeah, we don't. Well, we don't know. They're maybe just like Jehovah's Witnesses or Mormons or something. Like. Better to prepare for an attack. You're the heir to the Camus School of Swordsmanship, all right. You have the commander's instincts of your dad. So much exposition. All right. So let's go talk to the mayor. So when you played this at E3, was it just like a vertical slice from later on?
Yeah, it was a dungeon scene. Mm-hmm. It's just a sequence where you're going through fighting people.
I mean, I've played a little bit of this, so I know the combat seems interesting. It's a little weird though. I don't know if I like the fact that like so far every single cutscene is in this is it just in this exact same game engine and lets you move the camera around. Like I think I may be a little bit spoiled by Tokyo Mirage Sessions, like big sweeping camera moves and all kinds of crazy stuff.
Now you're getting fancy.
I know. So destructive that 5 years ago, my dad was asked to travel the country. Jesus God. To specifically teach locals how to defend themselves against these degenerates. Just for once, I want somebody to.
Wow, he just broke the fourth wall.
Yeah. Never hope to do anything against those savages, Mr. Mayor. But this is all too far over my head. I don't know the first thing about fighting. I want to be the mayor. I want to be the mayor for Halloween. So I'm going to cosplay the mayor. I'm going to go to a con. Cosplay as town.
You have to be. It's proverbial rock.
Town mayor. Well, is that his name? Fiddly? Might as well be him. I beg you, Fidel. Please deliver our home from certain doom. Oh, his name is Fidel? That's not something you see very often. Main character named Fidel.
Hmm.
You know. That and, you know, Adolf, Benito. There's a few out there.
Oi.
All right. Wow, we assembled these barrel barricades in a hurry.
Sophisticated defense techniques.
Yep. I don't understand. Like, his jacket looks like it was made in the year 4 billion, yet these townspeople are like, we better stack up a bunch of barrels in case the raiders come.
Well, I mean, they spent all of their budget on costuming.
Well, just on him, though. Look, everybody else is just wearing, like, I've just got some leather.
He's the resident pretty boy.
And some buckles, yeah. He's bankrupted the entire town. It's like Parks and Recreation, where he was the mayor and he spent all the town money on this jacket.
That coat is actually made out of solid gold, sapphires, and rubies.
Goddamn. Think we can hold out? Maybe once at most. Oh. Depending on their numbers. Once at most? Yes. Once at most? What is this, Metal Gear?
Come on, have some stamina, please.
Yeah. We'll ask the capital for reinforcements. Either way, let's not get ahead of ourselves. Whoa, whoa, whoa. So I don't know if you've been catching all this in the background, but they've got some kind of like bad like bandito problem in this town.
Bandito.
Yeah. And so for those of you wondering, I didn't go through the combat tutorial because it takes for frickin' ever, but like all this happens in real time, and you've got like a light attack and then like a heavy attack, and then if you hold down a button, you do these crazy attacks. And the whole thing has this like rock, paper, scissors thing where if you block a regular attack, then it stuns them. And if you hit when they're winding up for a big attack, it'll mess them up. And then if you heavy attack a block, it just goes right through it. But so far, as you can see, the screen is so goddamn covered in, like, flashing colored lights that I have a hard time
distinguishing who you're attacking.
Yeah, yeah, like, you know.
Yeah, and then there's this cancel bonus business. That I wasn't able to figure out what was going on with that.
Well, I think that when you hit the attack button that you, like, you do see it. When I hit the low attack button, I do two attacks. I go, like, one, two. But I think when you're in the middle of the first attack, if you hit the heavy attack or something like that, then you get an additional bonus to damage on top of that. It's really fiddly because it's not exactly like, because it's tri-ace and they're so weird. Like they made the last two Final Fantasy 13 games, I guess. Lightning Returns and then 13-2. Did you play those?
13, I did not. I played 10, and that was right around when I was going to college and kind of dropped off the face of gaming for a good 7 years.
Okay.
So I'm now getting back into things. I have 12 now, so I'm going to start playing that soon, and then I will probably play 13 after
that. No, don't play 12 now.
Why?
Because they're putting out like an enhanced remix HD version.
Well, somebody loaned it to me, so I've got it to play. I mean, I'm going to play Crisis Core first, and then I was going to play 12.
Okay.
But I mean, I could play other things and wait. That's a thing.
Yeah.
He's got like this super shiny like anniversary edition or something. Like it's in a metal box. It's all 12. Pretty. Yeah.
Is it? Because I know that they always put out like the international edition that has where they actually add back in a bunch of dungeons and. It's like before they had the ability to just patch a game, they used to do that where they would put out a second version like 3 years later that had like four new things and a bunch of DLC.
I think it's that one.
Okay. I have a really hard time getting into 12. I got some blueberries.
I've heard that. Blueberries. I like blueberries.
All right.
Yeah, I'm really excited. I actually was just given a Mac for work, so I'm going to be able to start doing PC gaming for the first time in ever.
Ooh.
I'm so excited. I've been getting the Geek Fuel boxes since November, and in each Geek Fuel box, they send you a game code.
Okay.
And I've not been able to play any of them because I was running on a 2009 HP laptop that couldn't do anything.
Right.
So now I've actually got a computer that's boss mode and I can play games. I'm so excited. I have no idea where to start.
What's the first thing on the list? What's the first thing
that
we're
going to
play?
Oh, God, I don't even know. Honestly, probably playing Settlers of Catan because I have that already and I know I love Catan.
Okay.
And it's my jam. It's my bae.
I guess I won't be hearing any more of your quips for a while. Make you sad. Oh, so like, who the fuck are you talking to?
But then I don't know. I'm gonna go troll through some Steam.
Yeah.
We were just having this conversation though. I need to figure out how to get Windows on this computer so that I can actually do stuff.
Yeah.
I've got a whole list of indie dev games that I want to play.
You should check out. You should check and see before the Steam sale goes away.
When does that happen? How much longer do we have?
It's on right now. I don't know. Like maybe another week.
Okay.
Maybe.
Yeah, I've got
maybe
time.
Just a couple of days. I don't know.
That's
but
okay.
You can buy stuff. I mean, you know, you don't even have to install Steam as long as you have an account. You can buy stuff. You might check and see if they have because I know that they did PC ports of. Final Fantasy 13, 13.2, and 13.3.
I think I saw that.
Of those, 13.2 is...
the best?
It is, but I don't know if you can play it without playing dumbass 13 first.
Yeah, I'll play 13. Like, I'll do it right.
Yeah.
I'll play them in order, just so that I can be knowledgeable of the current gen.
13 gets real weird.
I heard that.
Like, the Falci and the Lissi... Whoa, Shadowcat, what are you doing there?
Rare.
Sleazy bandits. Who are you talking to?
End of discussion.
What?
Wow.
What the hell?
Why is she sad? Now she's crying.
Is she crying or?
Yes.
Oh, that was fake crying. That crying was so fake. Look how you don't just recover from weeping on the ground.
And then you tell the fangirl to stick by your side. That's great.
I'm going to need to see your ID, Mickey. Yeah, 13.
Oh,
so 13.2. I don't know. 13.3 is weird because it's as near as I can tell, it's the only Final Fantasy game where you don't have a party. You just have one person that actually does all of the things.
Oh.
So it's just Lightning by herself, but then she can switch into. It's kind of like the dress spheres almost, where she can switch between. Three or four different like
skill sets, basically.
Yeah, at a time. It's real bizarre.
So you're saying that she is every woman?
Yes. Okay. Give me some blueberries. I can get some blackberries. There we go.
Ooh, get that fresh sage.
Nah, we'll have enough. We'll have enough time.
Kitty.
All right. So we are going to the Capitol to request reinforcements. Which is probably going to end up taking up most of the rest of this particular video.
Yay!
Yeah. I'm trying to decide whether or not for tomorrow, whether we should just pick up from wherever we end up here, or whether we should jump forward like 2 hours to when the game finally actually does a thing.
Ooh, look at that beautiful art.
So, let's see. I need to unlock... Oh, shit. I need some more crystals for that. All right. So now we're just in full-on, like, run around... Kill
grind
some
out,
monsters.
Grind out levels.
Yeah.
Yeah. What's that thing?
That is a save point. Shut up, game. I know what that is.
I thought you were telling me to shut up. I was about to be very mad. You were about to get hip checked. You didn't even know.
I didn't. It would have come out of nowhere. Here I am staring at the screen when the real danger is sitting right next to me.
We had a we had a bout last week for roller derby. It was like the last stage of evaluations for the new girls of the league.
Uh-huh.
The giant crab, dude. We're having dinner tonight.
Yep.
It's like a cyber
and they do this bout where they do the new girls versus the veterans, and it's always a slaughterhouse. Like this time it was 192 points to 2, I think.
Like that's just mean.
Really bad. Like the first time I've ever point refereed anything, and my arm started going numb from having to hold it above my head as lead jammer the whole time. Horrible. So we have this bout, and then during one point, one of the skaters, Mila Jukovic, who's a cherry bomb, she kind of ran into me on her way back to her bench for a jam.
Oh, shit.
And I was like, hey, bro.
Right.
She mouthed off to me something real funny. She's a really nice human being. So anytime she says something, it's usually joking.
Mm-hmm.
So she mouths off to me and says something. So I just kind of tackled her.
Mm-hmm.
And there's this hilarious picture of me with my arms around her, like holding her, and she's laughing her ass off.
Nice.
Hilarious. So yeah, tackles out of nowhere happen, bro.
Nice.
Just saying, watch yourself.
I will. I will remain constantly vigilant.
Check yourself.
So let's see. I'm trying
to decide. Before you wreck yourself.
Oh, yeah.
Get that chest.
It's locked. I don't know. I haven't gotten to that part of the game yet. It's
Boo.
Just like, meh. Somebody just, but what I'm really curious about is how the fuck this got out here. Like, is it just like old man Winters is like, man, I'm going to put that chest out there on the beach. I sure hope nobody opens
That's
it.
That's where I put my chest.
Oh, yeah?
Out just on the beach,
out
baby.
On the beach. Oh, bazinga! Oh, look, flying fish. Literally.
This is totally like the beach in Final Fantasy VIII.
Jerk fish!
These are the same creatures from Final Fantasy VIII, really, though.
Yeah.
And those blue dudes were like the blobs from 8. This is all Final Fantasy VIII, just different in 3D.
Yeah, I don't know. I was telling you before we started that the last Star Ocean game that I played, I think, was on the PlayStation 2. And then the last Tri-Ace game that I played... Oh, shit. Whoops.
Yeah, you did the thing.
Dude is dead. Can I? Nope. Okay. Do I have a spell maybe that I can use to signaturgy?
Signaturgy.
No. Okay. Damn. All right. He died real fast. That was kind of stupid. But all right. Maybe when we get done with this battle, he's just dead. Game's over.
Oh, now he's alive.
Start back over from the beginning. What? Well, how do
Way
I get him
go,
back to
bro.
Life?
You killed us.
Revive, recover. There we go. All right.
Told you wanted that first sage.
I did. I didn't listen. I'm a bad listener.
I know. It's okay. I still love you.
I think that... have you ever played Resonance of Fate?
No.
That was one of the last... I want to go back to him real fast. Tri-Ace games that I played. That's a real weird game, but it's really interesting. It was a PlayStation 3 game. We actually played it real briefly on Rage Select for one day where we didn't have anything to play on this one show that we do, and so John and I were just like, do you want to just play Resonance of Fate? But yeah, it's real strange. All right, so now we should be able to pick up some harvest things. There we go.
Shiny glitter rain.
There we go. Damn it. So yeah, I don't know how I feel about this whole combat system. It just feels really fiddly. I think it's one of those problems that I have with anytime you try to introduce real-time action into JRPG mechanics, I feel like it can really go either way. Like it can really be really good.
Agreed.
Or it can be really terrible.
I love turn-based roleplay. I just want to be able to take my time, guys.
Yeah.
That's all I want in my life.
Let's go through here. I'm trying to think of the last time that I played a Japanese game that had, like an RPG that had real-time combat that is not Dark Souls because, you know.
Right.
It's nice when you can say a game that is not Dark Souls. The main thing that I feel is kind of weird is just that all the normal hits in this game, I don't know if you got this when you were playing at E3, but all of just like the regular old run up to an enemy and hit the X button seems to be incredibly weak. Or like just for a regular enemy, it seems to take just tons of hits.
Yeah.
I mean, here's this regular guy, right? And here's just like brief regular hits. I mean, I guess maybe they want you to just definitely use all of the kind of like reversals on them, but 10 consecutive finishing blows. I got shellfish meat.
Mm.
Oh, shit.
Now I'm hungry.
Some big turtles. Some gamma turtles. Oh, damn it. Okay, fine.
Giant spikes, though.
There we go. So how many people did you have in your party when you were playing this, with the demo?
It was a bigger number. There were at least, like, 4 people, mm-hmm. I want to say.
Because so
far...
There was
a girl in a skin-tight bodysuit.
Uh-huh. The one with the checkerboard?
Yep.
Yep. The crazy witch with, like, a cat tail for some
reason.
Yeah,
that was awesome.
Hey, Miki, how about a quick heal here? Oh, why are you set to... Okay, this is wrong here. Why are you set to... I need you to go regular. God damn it. Somehow... Oh, okay, I see. Damn it. Nope. Heal. That's what it was.
What did you do?
Well, somehow I switched her over to, like, don't do anything unless I tell you to do it manually. So she wasn't doing her, like, little auto-healing bits. There we go. So out of the current crop of JRPGs, what do you think you're most excited for? Over the course of, I mean, we've got a lot coming out right now.
I want 15.
You want Final Fantasy 15?
I want it.
Yeah?
I want it real bad. I've actually been looking forward to this one for quite a while.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's been on my Amazon wish list for at least 6 months.
Uh-huh. What is it specifically about this game that has been interesting?
That's a good question, because I didn't play the others. I've seen them played, but I've not played them. Mm-hmm. There's just something in the art style that I very much love.
It's real, real crisp.
It's beautiful.
I was actually really surprised to learn. I was looking online, trying to not sound like the complete I've never played any of these games before dumbass before we started.
I think noob is the word you're looking for.
Yeah. I don't like that word. I don't like to use
well,
that word.
Oh, well, you are one, so get good, bro.
Apparently, like, this is a port of the PlayStation 3 version that came out, like, in April in Japan only. Like, they decided not to release the PlayStation 3 version domestically. I may have my dates confused about when it came out, but I swear when I was looking at it that it seemed like they put out the Japanese version on the PlayStation 3 in April, and they were just like, there aren't enough PS3s in the United States, or there aren't enough PS3s and people interested in JRPGs in the United States, or something like that. So they decided to only put out the PS4, and I don't know if there's an Xbox One version of this, but I know they didn't ask me today when I went to the store to get it. They were just like, here, PlayStation. Huh. But it's a little strange, because the last one of these that came out was in like 2009 or something like that. It was an Xbox 360 game. So, yeah. And this one's supposed to take place in between Star Ocean 1 and 2, which considering that I think that Star Ocean like 5 was the one that came out in 2009, they're really like kind of backing it up, like backing the series up to...
Back in the day.
Yep. Let's see. So where the fudgy fudge are we going? Okay, so right across
here.
Where
the fudgy fudge, folks?
That's right. Everything is Candyland in my head, so...
I'm okay with that.
Fudge Town, USA.
The costumes in that game were exceptional.
Candyland?
Yes.
The Candyland game?
Yeah.
Video game?
No, like board game.
Oh, okay. All right.
The only thing in my life that would ever make me want to do anything regarding licorice was that licorice dude. I would totally cosplay that shit.
Which licorice dude? In Candyland?
It's been
a long time.
The bad guy.
Was there a bad guy in Candyland?
He was one of the cards. Here, hold on. Let me find it.
I thought cards? Candyland cards are just like big squares with colors on them, aren't they?
Yeah, but weren't there other cards that did other things? It's been so long since I played that game.
I'm pretty sure, my recollection the last time, I think I had some cousins like 10 years ago that I tried to watch playing Candyland, and I was just like, oh man, this game is so for babies. Like, there's no, you pick a card.
You're
and then
for babies.
All you do is you pick a card and then you play it. Like, there's not a strategy to
You're
it.
You're for babies.
I am not for babies. This is, don't put that out in the world. Don't let somebody online is like, what's Rage Select? I'm going to let my toddler watch it. I heard it's for babies. It's not. It's not.
Lord Licorice was his name.
What? Who the hell is Lord Licorice?
Where's this guy?
Who the hell is Lord Licorice?
Look, he's this guy right here. Look at that. That costume's sexy. I'd wear that shit.
That's from, I think that you and I have played different versions of Candyland.
Apparently. Do you remember Princess Lolly?
I don't remember there being any characters. No, I don't know what that is.
This is Candyland, bro. do you even Candyland?
I'm going to have to pull. I think there was a new version of Candyland when you were young.
No, this is the original version.
Are you sure?
From way back in the day. Because look, that's the board. And look, there's the guy.
I don't remember any of this.
You never even really played Candyland. Lies!
I think I played it 30 years ago when I was 8 was the last time that I played Candyland.
And then there was Queen Frostine. She was always my favorite.
What? What do these people have backstories? Did they do anything? Oh, shit, who's this guy?
So Queen Frostine is the beautiful, like, ice princessy one. She was gorgeous.
I wanted
to be her.
Okay. I'm going to have to just say, you guys... This is the day I'm going on record to say I don't know shit about Candyland.
That's
I thought I did.
That's a better picture of him.
Yeah, that's
isn't that a great costume?
It's a pretty good costume.
I would cosplay that shit in a heartbeat.
Damn it, giant!
As a matter of fact, I think I'm gonna add that to my cosplay list.
Slime, you slime jerk. Yeah,
and
I don't
then
know.
Boom, Queen Frostine, bam.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't recognize any of this.
You
I don't recognize any of this.
Get over it, bro. You didn't even. You literally do not even.
I don't. No. And I, you know what? I can't even accept any kind of shame on that. It's like, hey, 38-year-old man, why do you mean you don't know anything about fucking Candyland? I'd be like, yes, that's fine. That's great. I think this dialogue is really stilted.
Oh.
Of course I did. How interesting. I never knew my master had a child.
That's what I say to my parents all the time.
Let me escort you to the next town. I love his boots.
Representatives of Stahl, we're on our way to ask the king for reinforcements. As for why we're doing that, it's because Adelon recently tried
to invade our... That's not how you would say that, Miki! You don't say, like, I don't say...
As for this is my motivation for everything in life.
Jennifer, we're all going to go to the Sizzler later. As for why, it's because we like their buffet. It's got many, many meats.
We do. We do indeed.
Thank you so very much.
All right, let's go.
Do you think the crown will help us?
Oh, my God, please let me walk faster. Please stop making me walk so slow. Who the fuck is Old Man Camus? Is he from Candyland?
Maybe. He could be.
Is he guarding the fucking jelly forest or whatever?
Yes. That's exactly it.
He is. That is but one reason it would behoove you not to call him an old man.
They should have changed the music.
I guess that makes sense. I'm walking into... I'm just like, all right, I've had enough.
Trying to walk on water.
Had enough of this game.
Thinks a lot of himself, doesn't he?
I'm leaving. Wait, is the sun going down, or am I just
Yes, the sun has been setting for a while now.
Okay.
It is now night.
I wasn't sure whether it was that or whether it was just my vision was slowly narrowing to a tiny pinprick because of this horrible dialogue.
I told you to lay off the drugs, bro. I tried to warn you.
I think I followed your advice, but I think that we're going to go the opposite way for JRPG week. Not fewer drugs, more drugs.
More drugs. Oh, goodness. Well, then in that case, you need to start sharing.
Yeah.
I am way too sober for
In
fact, I am completely sober, unless you count the pizza I had an hour ago.
Reach into the jar. You know, take a handful. There's it's assorted.
Oh,
there's
assorted.
Lots
That's
of stuff
exciting.
In there. Yeah. Yep.
All right. I'm down for this.
What?
I'm crashing on your couch later. Just letting you know.
Get a room. This is a JRPG. Well, you just go to the inn and you give them 30 whatever it is that you spend.
Yes, let's have a sleepover.
All right, let's do it. Let's go. Oh. Okay.
You're so salty. Why do you do a JRPG week if you hate JRPGs? I don't understand this.
You can't. Well, okay. So, like, it's some. Okay. I wanted to look at this game as well. I remember seeing the trailer for it originally. I definitely wanted to take a look at it because it's a brand new game. It's interesting. It's a thing that I'm kind of interested in. But, like, I don't, you know, I don't dislike all JRPGs.
Lies.
No. Like, last week there was this game called Grand Kingdom that we played that I thought was really, really fun. That was kind of like a combination of a strategy game and the Yawning Kobold. Isn't... that's weird. You pay. Fire Emblem Tokyo Mirage Sessions. That's just the right amount of, like, I want to be a pop star. Let's use our love and powers together.
And over the world with awesome.
But this one, I don't know. It might just be the fact that they look like, that whatever the engine that they're using, that their skin kind of looks like they're dolls, all those.
Yeah.
Wait, what are you... Are you complaining about how fast I wake up?
What in the name of... I make nice and wake you since the day's getting on, and yet...
It's really that late?
Yeah, it is.
It's like 7:15.
He went right. A while ago.
I see.
Uh-uh. None of that what? Now. Jeez, get going.
I'm going to make this like the alarm that wakes, this dialogue, the alarm that makes me, wakes me up in the morning. I think it'll last like 2 days until I pick up my
phone.
She's
way too goddamn perky.
Yeah.
Like, no.
Just go!
You're so cute when you sleep.
What?
Wow.
Good God. It's like they took anime and then boiled it down into like the most concentrated form, and then they just dipped that inside of a second anime, and
yes,
eesh, and then they deep fried it and covered anime sauce.
Delicious.
Sorry for keeping you.
Victor said he'll be waiting at the Western Gates.
Victor, gates. God.
Go Blondie.
Great.
All right. Ooh, cakes. Ooh, giant meats.
Yes.
Eat them. Diet Coke.
Wine. Yes.
Wine. They probably don't have Diet Coke in Star Ocean Integrity and Faithlessness.
They got wine, though. Woo!
All right.
Save, we should have save, a drinking save. Stream.
Oh, I've done that.
Let's do that sometime soon.
I've done that. Oof. It can,
not a crazy drinking stream, just a stream where we drink a little bit.
Yeah, I have a bit of an issue drinking in what would most people would consider sane fashion. So,
well, I'm not surprised based on your drunken Facebook messages that I've seen.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Not messages, comments.
There
hey
she is!
Girl!
Oh, yeah. I delete those almost immediately. That's why I always say to people when they try to friend me on Facebook, I'm like, you don't want to be my Facebook friend. That's got to be a really confusing outfit to be wearing. Like, wouldn't you just have, like, a weird amount of different temperatures just all over the place?
I'm just astounded by the fact that it's like her... I can't, like...
You can't? It's like, wow.
My brain won't even
do you just
process.
See, like, a blur on the screen right now? Is there...
I love her hat. Uh-huh. Her hair is exceptional.
Yep.
Her outfit from the waist down is great.
Uh-huh.
But the fact that it just completely and totally sculpts to her boobs.
Mm-hmm. Like it's literally painted on.
I have problems with this. It wouldn't work that way in real life.
Is it because your mind is trying to figure out how to make that thing
yeah
happen in real life?
It You're wouldn't like, happen.
I can't make it happen. Physics don't work that way.
They don't. They really don't. They don't cling to boobs like that.
Well, isn't there like a... You cosplay, isn't there like...
I mean, unless it's like...
Like glue, you just glue it on or...
I guess you'd have
double-sided
to.
Tape or something like that? Actually, that just seems like a bad idea. All right, give me some weapons.
Well, double-sided tape only gets you so far. I mean, your body heats up, you start sweating, and then the adhesive just starts coming off. Like,
yeah.
It's just not cute.
Okay. Fidel equipped leather armor. Give me some signature.
I do adore her hair and her hat, though.
The green hair?
Yeah. I would probably make this cosplay and just modify the top of it so that it actually makes sense for physics.
Could you just get like a bodysuit?
Yeah, I would just do a bodysuit.
Yeah, and then just throw
a little skirt on over the top of it.
Just get a magic marker, get a Sharpie, and then you just draw a bunch of squares and diamonds and shit all over the top.
I mean, yeah, if you didn't want to go to the trouble of making the suit in a Harlequin style. But, I mean, I think you'd have to do it from scratch.
Yeah. I guess here's the question.
If you're going to do it right.
This is the question is, if you make it, do you, like, with a skin-tight bodysuit, do you, like, add, like, boob padding in there?
Oh, God, yes.
Yeah?
I mean, for a chest like mine, yeah, you do.
Okay. But, and then this tail? Where is that even, how is that even attached to her clothing?
And through the bodysuit? I don't know.
I don't know. That's bizarre.
This girl's a hot mess of everything.
Again, it's like they just got out the anime shotgun and they were like, all right, stand still. All right. Well, what's our time look like over there? I have a feeling that we might be rolling a little bit over time. Okay. Oh, hold on.
Whoa.
We need to hear about what's happening.
Things don't look good for us.
Uh-oh. Which one is us,
I'm
Jennifer?
Going for red.
The blue one? The yellow one?
I'm going for red.
The red one? Okay. Seems the enemy has developed a new weapon. Because it looks like a face. Got a little smiley face down at the bottom. Such as?
I won't pretend to understand. Better, I just like the color red.
Yeah. Supposedly attack from great distances and is far more destructive than our most advanced signature gene. It's like an arrow? New type of weapon? Sounds like a scapegoat to me. The fact that we're losing is Does true. It? And so is the fact that no signaturges in the field can discern why. This... And I've been called... Our nation has always had a close and congenial relationship with the Eastern Kingdom of Langdon. Now we must call upon them for aid in unraveling this mystery, as they possess the finest signaturgical research facility on the planet. I really wish they would stop saying that word. So that's how it is. I don't know why it's messing with my brain.
Signaturgical?
Yeah. Okay. So we're good to go? Where are we going? Central Resulia. All right, well, I tell you what, we are going to wrap it up because there is nothing between here and Central Revlublia outside
except for these cute little bunny things.
You mean the plant monsters?
Is that what those were?
This is giant walking plant monsters and, like, giant bees, giant hornets.
Yep.
But now we've got, like, a whole party, so this just turns into literally nothing.
Cannon fodder.
Yep. All right, so let's wrap it up. Hey, folks, if you are watching this on YouTube, hit the like and subscribe button. If you would like to see these videos a day earlier, you can always head on over to RageSelect.com, where we have all kinds of good things. I fixed the website. It doesn't crash your browser anymore.
Yay!
It's really something that should have happened.
I hated it when that happened.
A long time ago.
It made me sad.
Yeah. Now I have to do is figure out how to unfix it so that I can fix it again.
Fair. That's fair. Hey, check out the Patreon page for Rage Select as well, because we like playing shiny video games for you.
Yep.
But we got to pay those bills.
Yep.
You know, sometimes the landlord likes it when we pay rent and things.
Yeah.
It's a good thing. So check out the thing. You get all the extra videos and bonus stuff and shiny accolades and our undying gratification.
All of it.
It's good stuff.
Yeah.
We love you guys.
Yeah.
Love us back.
Patreon.com/RageSelect.
Do it.
Let's see. Also... Amazon, if you want to buy Amazon,
yeah.
There should be some Amazon links down below.
Buy the stuff.
If you start at our page. What are these things? They're just like ducks.
They're giant, adorable.
Giant, slaughtering all the giant ducks.
Yeah, if you want to play Star Ocean,
yeah.
Follow the Amazon link. Buy the thing off of the link, and then we get the little bit of the scratch from the thing. It's a good thing.
Yep. It still amazes me that Amazon does that. They're just like...
Makes me happy.
Yep. Well, speaking of making you happy, you have your own Patreon and channels. Why don't you tell the people about that?
I am Mayhem's Muse. You can find me on Twitch. I do lots of JRPG streams and other kinds of streams. You can find me on Patreon, Mayhem's Muse. You can find me on Twitter, on Instagram, on Facebook, all the things. Mayhem's Muse.
All right. Snapchat.
I don't Snapchat. That's the one social media element that I do not do.
Okay.
Too many creepsters and penis pictures. I'm not into that, bros.
That's wow. Really that's not. The same reason I had to leave myself. Yeah. All right. Well, join us back here tomorrow where we may or what are you? Is this lady? Is she just touched? Does she need?
She's just dancing.
Do I need an adult?
Just dancing. Let her dance.
Okay. Where? Oh my! Tell me I can make my character walk like that. Anyway, join us back here tomorrow for part two of Star Ocean Integrity and Faithlessness. I'm not sure where we're going to start from. It may be here. It may be somewhere else. But it will be somewhere, that's for sure. So we'll
see
you then.
The point is, it'll be this game.
Yes. So thanks, everybody, for watching, and have yourselves a lovely evening.
Thank you, and good night.